Tad Paramhamsa Parivajakacharya Ashtavata Ashtatatatatatatatatatatatatat Shri Shri Vankas Bhakti Vedanta Swami Shri Prabhupada Ki Shri Pada Paramhamsa Parivajakacharya Ashtavata Ashtatatatatatatatatatat Shri Shri Vankas Bhakti Siddhanta Adar Shivas Adigaura Bhakta Vrindiki Jai Shri Shri Radha Krishna Goputika Radha Kunda Shama Kunda Giriga Vedan Ki Jai Vrindavan Mathura Dham Ki Jai Mayapur Navadip Dham Ki Jai Shri Shri Jagannath Puri Dham Ki Jai Shri Nasik Dham Ki Jai. All glorious to assembled devotees, all glorious to assembled devotees, all glorious to assembled devotees. Kaliyuga Pavan Shri Harinama Sankirtan Yajna Ki Jai. Srila Prabhupada Transcendental Book Distribution Ki Jai. All glorious to Sri Guru and Gauranga, all glorious to Srila Prabhupada. Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshushan Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. I'm going to tell after that.
Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsha Shri Rupam Sagra Jatam Sahagana Raghunatam Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadhavaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Pada Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakam Vitamsha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpati Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vishamanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Bhyasha Kripa Sindhu Bhyaye Vacha Patitanam Pavane Bhyo Vaishnave Bhyo Namo Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tinamine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivas Adi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. First, I think we should spread the dari so that everyone can see it's cold, stone, it's cold. You can spread the dari and everyone can accommodate in the dari, so it will be comfortable. We are sitting at one of the very special places in Nasik. One of my favorite deities also. It's a very special temple here where Lord Lakshman's deity is worshipped. And there's a beautiful deity of Hanumanji, very, very ancient deity, very, very beautiful deity. So, and this place is known as Tapavan. Everyone knows very easily what is tapa. Tapa means tapasya, austerity. And one means forest. Tapavan, the forest where tapasya has been performed. By whom? By Lakshman. So, this temple is a symbol of, you know, Lakshman's austerity. Lakshman has performed austerity here, you know, because he would not sleep. In Ramayana, the whole story comes up. As I had mentioned yesterday, Lord Ramachandra, once Dasharath was actually early in the morning, he was just getting ready and he was coming to his palace, to his ministerial quarters. And before he was coming, he was putting his helmet. And while he was putting his helmet, he saw some white hairs on him. And he realized that I'm getting old now. And I should immediately make Ram, my eldest son, who is very qualified, and make him the king. And I can retire and perform devotional service peacefully by giving responsibilities to Rama. With this thought, he went to his ministers and his assembly there, where he would have Brahmanas, Vaishnavas like Guru Vasishtha, and ministers like Sumanta. And he expressed his desire and explained them that I am getting old and I want to make my eldest son Rama as the king of Ayodhya. And I want all of your opinions, Guru and the ministers. What is your opinion on this? I want your thought on this. The Ramayana mentions that when all of them heard that they are going to make, Dashrath Maharaj is thinking like this, to make Rama the king, they were very happy. They were in very much bliss. There was no, limit to their happiness. It appeared as if they were also living to see Ram becoming the king. To see Lord Ramachandra becoming the king. The qualities of Lord Ramachandra is described in Ramayana. An ideal son. Right from the childhood, being an elder brother, he would be most respectful to his father, to mother, and take care of all the brothers very nicely. Sometimes he would play with them and the brothers would lose the game. He would again play and he would himself lose the game to give them pleasure. And he would always act in a way as if he's the mother and father for all the three brothers. And everyone saw this, how Lord Ramachandra was so respectful. He would respect the ministers and the guru of Ayodhya as if he is respecting the spiritual supreme personality of Godhead. In this way, Lord Ramachandra exemplified his beautiful qualities. In fact, it is mentioned that when Rama was growing, he was a center of attraction for everyone. And when he grew up as a young boy, after he came back from the Gurukul, it is said that everyone's eyes had pleasure only in looking at Rama's beauty. His beauty, his body was very built, well built, chest was up, broad shoulders, greenish form, lotus-like eyes, and very, very bright face. Anyone who would see Lord Rama would just get mesmerized. Whenever Lord Ramachandra would pass through his chariot in Ayodhya, it is mentioned that practically Ayodhya would stop. Ayodhya would stop. This is how Lord Ramachandra's beauty is described in Ramayana. And with these qualities, Ramachandra is described and he was living. And those ministers and Guru Vasishtha with his disciples was personally experiencing all this thing, and they are hearing that now Dasharatha is desiring to make Rama the king. And this is what they also wanted. They were living for it. And those Dasharatha Maharaj asked, they said, we all support this decision. So then he said that, I request all of you, please look at a very auspicious day and auspicious tithi so that we can decide and we can do all the arrangements to make Lord Rama the king, our Rama the king. So kindly do all these things. They all discussed and they said, our king, our great Dashrath Maharaj, Lord Rama's qualities are glorified in three worlds. We don't have to check anything, any auspicious moment to make Rama the king. The moment Ram becomes the king, it becomes the most auspicious moment. Even the moment is purified, even the time is purified when Ram decides to become the king. And Dashrath Maharaj was so happy. He said, then when? He said, Shubha Shigram, early the best. How early? They said, tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning. Oh yeah, Dashrath Maharaj said, fine. If it is accepted by the Guruvar and the ministers, it is my decision also. This is how the Vedic kings used to take decisions. They would take the advice of the ministers and the Brahmanas. And based on their advice, when they would see something which is higher, they would take that decision. Nowadays they have meat and drink, ministers One side they will have meat, other side they will have alcohol, and they will take decisions. You know. But in the Vedic time, it was like that. That's how they are king. Prabhupada says, the first people who have a reservation in the hell are the ministers or the politicians. Why? Says, praja or the citizens of a city or a kingdom, what they are actually, the king is supposed to take care of them like their own children. And whatever sins they do, some percentage goes to king. That is why they were supposed to guide the citizens to be very godly and sinless. Pure life and sinless life. Spiritual life, and they are aware, they are educated what is sin, what is papa. That because they have the fear that they will also get the sin if the citizens do the sin. Now the ministers are doing sin and the citizens are doing sin in wholesale. It will all go to the ministers. Yeah? Imagine their gati. But Vedic time it was like this. They would take the advices of the ministers and brahmanas, Vaishnavas. So when Dashrath Maharaj decided, all together decided, they called Lord Ramachandra and told him that, Rama, tomorrow we plan to do your Rajya Abhishek. Get ready and fast tomorrow morning. You and Sita have to sit on the Yajna. Lord Ramachandra, as a respectful son, paid obeisances to his father. He said, as a service, I accept. And then the news spreaded in whole Ayodhya. That tomorrow Ram is going to become the king and his Rajya Abhishek is going to be performed. Whole Ayodhya has to be decorated and there is a celebration. And if you read Ramayana, there is a description of how the citizens and the soldiers and the ministers, they were preparing for Rajya Abhishek celebration of Lord Ramachandra. Few things which I can say is that the elephants were carrying drums of perfumes from the chambers from the palace of Lord Rama to the main palace of Ayodhya. And they were cleaning the streets with perfume. They're cleaning the streets with perfumes. The whole Ayodhya was lit up. From the night only, Ayodhya was shining with all lamps everywhere. All the citizens, it is said, elderly citizens of Ayodhya, they were crying because they were thinking that will we see this moment in this lifetime? Because they were waiting also to see Rama as the king. All the young ladies, women, men, children, everyone was busy preparing something as a celebration. So in this way, Ramayana describes the whole situation of Ayodhya. As soon as it was announced, it spread. So now what happened in the heavenly planets, there was a shock to all the demigods. Demigods, they were in fear. They were practically shivering. They all went to Brahma and they told Brahma, "Are, what is this? We already had gone to the Supreme Lord and prayed him. And the Lord said, I am going to appear soon. And he is going to kill all the Rakshasas. Rakshasas are spread around in the whole planet. And Lord Rama is going to sit in Ayodhya. Who will go and kill the Rakshasas? We are worried about our future. We are worried. Ravana can come anytime, take over the whole heavenly planets. Do something." Ramaji also said, "What can I do? Dashrath decided suddenly. So you should do something." He said, "Okay, fine, I'll do." They all went to Saraswati Devi. He said, "You do something, Devi." So Saraswati said, "Okay, let me think." So Saraswati Devi came down. And she was searching for someone whom she could inspire to create a disturbance, you know. And she wanted a very unqualified person, because unqualified people are chosen by the Lord for unqualified work, you know. It's like, you know, a place where you have to split. You will split that place only, correct? Correct? So she was searching and then she found out. One lady, hunchback, doesn't take bath also properly, always busy in manipulating and speaking lies, you know, always busy with this activity. So she thought that this lady is the best lady. Who was that?
Mantra.
So she went and sat in Mantra, Saraswati Devi. And immediately Mantra saw, she was searching. That whole Ayodhya has been decorated. Just suddenly what has happened? And she heard that, she asked the soldiers and the maids, "Are, what is happening here? What are you people doing? There is no festival coming up now. Why are you busy so much decorating and cleaning?" He said, "Arey Baba, tomorrow Ram is going to become the king. Tomorrow is Raj Rahul. Our Lord Ramachandra's Rajya Abhishek." She heard it. Her face was dry. She was disturbed, disappointed, almost crying. And she went running to Kaikai. Went running to Kaikai and started crying there. So Kaikai said, "What happened, Mantra?" Said, "Nothing." Said, "What happened? Why are you so much disturbed?" He said, "No, I am very unfortunate. I am just praying to the Lord to give me death before tomorrow morning." "So why are you speaking like this, Mantra?" "Say, no. Why am I alive?" She was starting beating her chest. She said, "Dada, what happened? Say, did someone do anything? Did someone do anything? Are, did Lakshman beat you up or what?" So Radha Govind Maharaj says that she was such a cheap lady. Maharaj bolte hain ki शायद लक्ष्मण कभी कभी इसको ठोकते थे, इसकी पिटाई करते थे कभी कभी. दैट एंड शी वुड डू सम मिस्टेक, लक्ष्मण बीट हर, यू नो. सो दैट इज व्हाई शी आस्क्ड हिम, हर, व्हाट हैपेंड, डिड लक्ष्मण बीट यू अप अगेन? से नो, नथिंग लाइक दैट, यू नो. देन व्हाट इज द मैटर ऑफ योर डिसअपॉइंटमेंट? व्हाई आर यू क्राइंग लाइक दिस? ही सेड, नो, डू यू नो दैट there's a whole preparation going on in Ayodhya? "Yeah, I'm also observing it, that there is a whole preparation going on in Ayodhya. Suddenly, it has begun." She said, "Are, not suddenly, already now from 15 days the preparation is going on." "Acha, 15 days preparation is going on? For what? For what the preparation is going on from last 15 days? She said, "Dasharatha has decided to make Rama the king of Ayodhya." As soon as Kaikai heard this, there was no limit to her happiness. She said, "What are you telling?" She removed a golden necklace from her neck and threw on Kaikai. Kaikai, that, "What are you telling? Oh, this is a moment even I was living for. What can give me more pleasure than hearing this news that my Ram is going to become the king of Ayodhya?" It is said that Lord Ramachandra, Kaikai was very dear to Dasharath Maharaj. And because she was very dear to Dasharath Maharaj, Lord Ramachandra used to worship her like Dasharath Maharaj. He used to, when he would wake up, before paying obeisances to his own mother Kaushalya, he would go and pay obeisances to Kaikai. Practically, he would call Kaikai as Ma and his own mother Kaushalya as Badi Ma, Big Mother. So much affection, so much love. So much respect he gave to Kaikai that even Kaikai was in ocean of pleasure hearing that Rama is going to become the king of Ayodhya. And this way the conversation went on, and she was just remembering Rama, and she was just glorifying, and she was sharing the qualities of Rama to Kaikai. And for Kaikai it was like someone is piercing her with thorns, you know, because Paipai was very envious. She was very jealous. So Kaikai just kept on Mantra was very envious. Mantra was very jealous. So Kaikai kept on glorifying, and practically she had tears in her eyes while glorifying Lord Rama's qualities and sharing her happiness. Then Kaikai started shouting and crying more loudly that, "Why am I living to see this day? Oh, foolish Kaikai, you don't know what is happening here." He said, "What is happening? Rama is going to become the king." "No. If you carefully observe, Rama is going to become the king. But nobody knows about it. The preparation is going on 15 days. And today it is out. And you see one thing? Did you notice one thing? Bharat and Shatrughan are not there. What is the hurry to make Rama the king? They could wait for Bharat to come. They could make Bharat to come, wait. And they could officially announce it. They could tell you why is the reason. Think nicely. Think properly. Think deeply. Why the he has to be announced to make a king without informing you? Oh, tell me, oh queen, did anything happen in Ayodhya till today without informing you? She was actually lying. It just happened in the morning, afternoon. And Dasharatha Maharaj was busy throughout the day and he was supposed to come and inform Kaikai. First he came to inform Kaikai only, but she started lying. The preparation started from the afternoon. She's telling it's going on from last 15 days. This is the nature of the people who are overly attached in the material world. Lies dances in their tongue. Whenever there is a situation, they immediately lie. Just to cover themselves. And everything begins from lie. Because to one lie, one lie is what you have to do? And to cover the second lie? And to cover the third lie? And whole life you have to keep speaking lies. And you cannot justify. And then lies becomes your quality. Isn't it? And who will like a liar? Who will like a cheater? Who will like an envious person? Because all these qualities comes with... Because when you are overly attached in the material life, you want to lie, you want to speculate, you want to justify, and then you want to get something out what you like. So Kaikavi exemplifies that. Mantra exemplifies that. And then she said that, see, all this is happening here. You are not aware. He said, Mantra, if you speak all this nonsense, no, I will get your tongue cut. You know, on this auspicious moment, don't remove the garbage of your mouth. Don't release the garbage of your mouth on this auspicious moment. Then she said, I have no problem. Nothing is going to happen to me. It is my foolishness that I am so attached to you. Why don't you do one thing? You take that sword or you take that armor, just break my head here. So I can die here only. Because if I am living, I will speak for your welfare. It's better that I die. And it's better to die with your hands. So Kaikai was... What Mr. Kaikai did is, she kept on giving attention and started discussing with Mantra. Immediately she had to reject anyone who is speaking something which is or obstacle to Krishna consciousness. One has to give up that. You know? But that was the biggest mistake. And moreover, she was sharing. It is mentioned in Ramayana that she was very personal with Mantra. Mantra is a very low class lady. One has to be very conscious and cautious whom to associate with. People who are very low class, people who are very cheating propensity, should be very confident. Because it has, association has a very, very, very big impact. You know? Saraswati Devi sat in the tongue of Mantra and converted her brain. Okay? But you will see, Mantra, just by her association and preaching, diverted the mind or polluted the mind of Kaikai. That association, that speech, hearing from someone has such an impact. As I told you yesterday also, you know, just someone comes and tells you, today night, keep the door closed properly before you sleep. Just someone tells you, aap sone ke pehle darwaja theek se band kar dena. Ab darwaja band kya? You will put bed and stones and rocks and everything to close the door. And after doing that, you will not sleep also whole night. Isn't it? Kyu bola, kyu bola, kyu bola. Kya hone wala hai? So such is just by hearing someone, it has such an impact, you know. So again, Mantra started a drama. Devi, nothing is going to happen to me. Rama will become the king. Kaushalya's position will increase because her son has become the king. Okay, Dasharatha is going to remain as he is. I I am going to be on my position. By Rama becoming the king, I am not going to get a very great increment. There is not going to be increment in my salary. You know, my position is not going to increase. But Dashrath is old, he may die any time. Kaushalya will make you a maid here and Bharat will minister, become a minister. Pain will be for you. You will be like a dasi. This is the whole plot. As soon as Kaikai heard this word, dasi, 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 immediately she got polluted. No, I cannot become a dasi, she said. But what can I do now? This is my destiny, I feel so. And this is why she also laments. See the power of association. Kaikai was so happy that she gave her, immediately she gave out her jewelry, her pearls, necklace, to Mantra. As soon as she heard, and she was celebrating, she was enjoying, she was in pleasure. But later on when she heard this, let's see what is the impact. Immediately, that's the power of association. We all come in association, we chant and we dance, isn't it true? But we only do one mistake. We don't choose to remain in association when we are in association. We don't take a vow that whenever I'm free, I will go and be with devotees only. Because we don't preach ourselves the value of association. And when you don't do that, there's innumerable mantras available in the world. Who will just come, not only world, our mind is full of mantra only. Yeah? Isn't it true? Immediately, within a second it will turn our mind and finished. We'll be busy serving Maya. That is why our decision has a very big role in Krishna and Guru to guide us and help us. Krishna's energy is Yoga Maya and Mahamaya. Mahamaya is for the people who want to sleep in Maya's lap. Yoga Maya, when one takes spiritual decisions, Yoga Maya, she actually makes arrangements for a person who's desiring spiritual. So that he can go for more yatras, he can go for more camps, he can associate with devotees, he can get more prasadam, he can get more Krishna katha. Yoga Maya arranges all these things. Krishna arranges through his energy for a devotee. What we have to do is what? Tell me. What we have to do? Tell. Be in the association, and I am searching for exact word. Okay, desire to be in association. What else?
Take a vow to.
Very nice. Take a vow or take a decision to be remain in association. I have seen many devotees who have taken this decision. They are so blissful, always. I have seen so many. I have seen Nishit Prabhu coming from the day one to the temple, and he decided one point that no. I will go to my office, and when I'm free, I'll be in the temple. I'll worship, I'll get married to devotee only and serve devotees only. And I can see, I have seen Madhur Kanai Prabhu, I have seen Shubhankar, and I've seen this boy, he just came to the bus last year, right? What's your name? I forgot. Ashutosh. When he came, he was looking different, then now he's looking different. Do you see a change in your life? There's a change in your life, no, after the bus? Tell me. Yeah, I witnessed him just 8 months, 1 year, right? Not in over a year. You decide it, right? To be in association, and you see so much change in our life. Do you feel the change in your life? It's the decision. It's our decision which changes the life and attracts the mercy of the Lord. For devotees, there is only mercy. They have to just attract it towards them. And Maya is overflowing. You don't have to do. Just be there. Without association, you will float in Maya. Maya slapping us, kicking us every day. It's a false bodily relationship, false material identification. Kaikai says once to Mantra, Mantra teri mathi mari gai hai. तुम्हारी मथे मारी गई है your brain is just gone mad you're crazy this is our situation in kali yuga hum sab ki mathi mari gayi hai maya mein isn't it and just busy so much we preach where it goes I don't know I'm always praying to the lord to qualify me because I think I am so unqualified Because we speak the same thing, where it is going. But I'm very happy to see some of the young devotees are taken up so seriously. We always want to be, see everyone wants to be hero in their life, isn't it true? Anyone thinks I'll become a hero, I'll become a villain. Even the ugliest man thinks that I look like a Shah Rukh Khan. You know, that's the nature in the youth, correct? Isn't it true? थोड़ा सा ऐसा होता तो मैं दिखता था मगर ऐसे तो दिखता ही हूँ इज़न्ट इट ट्रू सो यूथ इज लाइक दैट फुल ऑफ लाइक दिस यू नो करेक्ट बिकॉज वी डोंट नो व्हाट इज रियल हीरो वी नेवर एजुकेटेड अबाउट व्हाट इज रियल हीरो दैट इज व्हाई वी थिंक दैट दिस सो कॉल्ड हीरोज़ हु आर गोइंग टू गेट ओल्ड एंड डाई विद इन 100 ईयर्स दे आर हीरो एंड आफ्टर दे डाई यू वांट अनदर हीरो बट लॉर्ड रामचंद्र इज सच अ हीरो Every generation is repeatedly hearing and is attracting the hearts of everyone, you know. There was Raj Kapoor who was a great hero. Now you hear about him. It will not attract your heart. You like to hear about the latest hero. Correct? Because material things are temporary. Material heroism and the material heroes are temporary. Death swipes them away. And they die suffering. Correct? But real heroes, Lord Ramachandra, Lord Krishna, Hanumanji, Lakshmana, They are real heroes. They are the real role models. When we contemplate about them, our heart is so pure. Correct or not? And these so-called heroes, we are actually fooled by the society. Truth we don't know. See, Shah Rukh Khan will fly. But if he fly really, he'll break his bones. There will be a gaddi. Have you seen shooting? I born and brought up in Mumbai, in the heart of Bollywood, seven bungalows, Lokhandwala. We have seen shooting, you know. The hero will go up, there will be a big bed here. He will fail on that. And when you've seen the movie, he stands on the... Thak karke stand. And we all think that, you know, we will go in the garden, jump. You know, childhood, we do all that, you know. You know? And if you do like that, we'll break our legs. Real hero is not Rama, not Krishna. They are the real heroes. God, if you know about him, But if you don't know about him, they say, अरे ये सब हो सकता है क्या ये सब सच में है क्या किसने देखा है लाइक दैट यू सी अरे बाबा साइंस इज शोइंग यू व्हाट दे नॉट शोइंग यू एनीथिंग नथिंग दे जस्ट दे आर विनिंग फेथ ऑन अस कम्स विथ एवरीथिंग केम बाय चांस करेक्ट डार्विन्स थियरी एंड यू एक्सेप्ट दिस थियरी एंड एक्सेप्ट देम एज गॉड And then whatever they say to truth, it becomes a truth. And so-called materialist becomes our heroes. You know? But Prabhupada mentioned that how can anything come by chance? How can anything come by a... I just recently was reading Prabhupada's, hearing Prabhupada's conversation. So he said, Prabhupada's one disciple, Swarup Damodar Maharaj, he mentions Prabhupada. Prabhupada, the scientists, they say everything came by chance. You tell them to show me one thing which is in their existence which came by chance. Tell them only to show. In the current situation, something which came by chance. No, Prabhupada, they say there was a big explosion. There was a big explosion. And then from that explosion, creation took place. Prabhupada told, there are so many explosions, there are so many wars now. We never see after a battle, there is a city created. Tell them to prove that. They say, Prabhupada, they... No, they say there was a gas. That gas exploded. Prabhupada said, who put the gas there? They say, Prabhupada, they say that it came by nature. Prabhupada said, yes, that is what I'm asking, whose nature it is. It has to belong something, no? Anything in this world has been possessed by someone. Like this land is there, we are discussing, we are walking. If we sit there and say it belongs to us, someone will come and say, government will say, vacate it. Or some owner will come and say it belongs to me. Correct? Even if you go to the forest, nowadays ministers will say this is forest vibhag, forest department. So in this way, how can something just exist like that? Who has put the gas there? Whose nature it is? So then Prabhupada said, this rascal scientist, they don't know someone is doing everything. But they are so rascals, we tell them we know who has done it, they don't want to accept that also. This is arrogance. If you don't know something, I am telling you, sir, here is it, why don't you accept it? Understood my point? If you understand this, no, your life is successful. Your faith on God will increase. Simple. Did I speak anything very, you know, lofty, a very difficult language? You know, sine, cos, theta, C2, 1, 3, F2, H2, or nothing. Simple language. Very, very simple. Prabhupada, simple. Prabhupada would meet the scientist. Okay. You are saying the supernatural power is there, this is there. When I am telling you it is Krishna, what is the problem in accepting? Scientists are, you know, scratching their hands and pinching their own hands, you know. Makes sense, but it is difficult, Prabhupada said. Why it is difficult? When you don't know something, I am telling you what is the difficulty? And they had no answer. Because they just want to fool us, because they are fools. And they want to accept their foolishness only. And Prabhupada is the only acharya who questioned this. And we are, that's why, very fortunate to come in contact with this acharya. This movement is called. Understood? Understood my point or not? This is ABC of defeating material civilization, a modern civilization, or scientific civilization. This is the ABC. You don't need to know verbs, adjection, nouns, nothing. Just this much you tell them. Once Prabhupada was with one scientist, and Srila Prabhupada's disciple Swarup Damodar Maharaj was also there. So Prabhupada asked that, he's the scientist, that, can you create life? He said, we are working very hard in our laboratory. Very soon we will create a life. So Prabhupada said, he's scientist Maharaj. He said that, so they are telling that they are going to create, in future they are going to create life. So what do you think about it? They are giving a post-dated check. Prabhupada, they don't have any answer what you are saying. They are giving a post-dated check. Prabhupada said, what does that mean? They are cheaters, Prabhupada. They are cheaters, Prabhupada. Till date, they are not created life. And one thing is there, they are not creating anything. They are only discovering God's creation. This is knowledge. This is a word with knowledge. Speaking with knowledge. You understood? Science is not creating anything. They are only discovering things. What is already there. Correct? And their current inventions is devastating humanity and human relationships. Take for example, smartphone. There was a time when there would be a letter coming from one city to another city by a brother and father. Reading that, there would be tears in the eyes. Because there would be so much emotions. Now people are fighting with distance of lakhs of kilometers on a WhatsApp, on internet. Isn't it true? No? People have become impersonal. You know. Now there was one photo which came on the YouTube. Birthday celebration 10 years ago, birthday celebration today. 10 years ago, they were having cabs, they were celebrating, dancing, and now all in the phone. All birthday photo, and everyone is in the phone. So we have developed. The science has really taken us to a different level. But what has happened to our relationship today? You can see that? He says, there is a research which says that practically, most of the people in the world are victim or having the disease of attention disorder. You know this? You know this? Attention disorder. They are trying to develop a curriculum so that in the schools also, teach students will be taught 15 minutes, after that they'll play for 5 minutes. Again 15 minutes they will teach. Then again 5 minutes they'll pray. Why, you know? Due to internet and smartphone, people are so much into all these things, they don't have the energy to sit and hear and be attentive to anyone. We are fortunate, we came quite late. I'm talking about a generation which has just come with this smart technology. Have you seen all that or not? You know, nowadays, mother will keep... So child, give a phone to a child, he'll busy. Mother is busy with another phone, son is busy with another phone. And father is busy with another phone. Has devastated the society today. Devastated the culture today. So, this is the Kali Yuga mantras. So, mantra, when she saw that you'll become a dasi, Kaikeyi immediately woke up to her insecurity. She said, now what can I do? This is my fortune, mantra. But I'm very grateful to you. You are coming and giving me this information. You are my real well-wisher. You are my true friend. You know, just see what happens when you associate with such people. And then, now what can I do? This is my gati. Mantra says, no. Rani, there is one hope still. What is that hope? There is one hope. What? I will tell you at one condition. Provided that you promise me that you will follow that. In this whole creation, who is my well-wisher except you, mantra? Just few moments ago, she is telling, Rama is everything for me. And just in association of mantra, by hearing her, giving her her ears, in few moments, what is she telling? You are my only well-wisher in the whole creation. Tell me what. She said, do you know, when you have protected, when there was a big battle between demigods and the Rakshasas, you had intervened and you have protected Dasharatha Maharaj in that battle. Dasharatha was wounded, you took care of him. And Dasharatha gave you 2 bones. Dasharatha gave you 2 bones. Now you should ask Dasharatha, call him and ask him for these 2 bones. He said, what is the value of those 2 bones? He said, no, I will tell you what you should ask. So what should I ask? For the first boon, you tell Bharat will become the king. And for the second one, you tell like Bharat becoming the king is fine, but Ram, why I should tell him? He said, yahi to main bol rahi aapko, tum samajhti nahi ho kai kai. You know, now she was a queen and she's become the queen now. You know, she said, tum samajhti nahi ho. Ram sarva guna sampanna hai. Until Ram remains here, nobody will accept Bharat the king. That is why Ram goes away and Bharat gets the time enough to become the king and get the whole control. He said, oh, most beautiful Kaikeyi, come mantra. There is no one intelligence as you in this 3 creation. And she was a hunchback, old, bended lady, you know. Then Dasharatha Maharaj actually comes to, Dasharatha Maharaj with great pleasure, he comes to meet Kaikeyi and he informs the queens, the maids that, please inform Kaikeyi the king is coming. Immediately she comes. But she, before that, mantra tells her that you do one thing, you go and sit in Kupa Bhavan. In the Vedic time, the kings would have specific places for specific purpose. There would be an assembly. Ministers would sit, brahmanas would sit, the kingdom's decision would be taken there. There would be a separate palace for the king, there would be a separate palace for the prince, there would be separate palaces for daughters. There would be a separate palace called Kupa Bhavan, separate chambers called Kupa Bhavan, where when there is a sorrow, the whole family would sit together and cry and discuss. So she told you, go and sit in Kupa Bhavan. And wear old clothes, don't have any jewelry. And then you fell down on the floor and cry. Just see how detailed guidance she is giving. This is how Maya is. She guides you to detail to cheat you. You know, she'll give you detailed guidance to fell more deep in Maya. So, and then when Dasharatha comes, you just keep crying and don't immediately tell him. Keep crying and then tell him in the last. Take a vow from him again that if you tell me that you will fulfill what I am telling you, then only I'll tell you what I desire. I said, okay. She went and said, she kissed Mantra, Kai Kai, and then she went. No? She kissed on the forehead. She said, you are so nice and so dear. And she went. Maya becomes so dear to us, you know, when we are association of non-devotees. Then, Lord Dasharatha Maharaj comes and he said, Kai Kai is in Kupa Bhavan. She said, why Kupa Bhavan? Who has given pain to my queen? And immediately goes to Kupa Bhavan and he asks Dasharatha, Kai Kai, what happened to you? Kai Kai is just crying. Kai Kai, what happened to you? Kai Kai is crying. I don't know how many of you have seen. Anyone who's been in a joint family and have seen mother crying. Father is helpless. Husband is helpless. You know, mother is crying. Are kya hua bada? You know, there was one devotee who had come to stay in the temple for a few days. And the parents were against being a devotee. But somehow or other he pushed and came. And he stayed for a few days. And the mother called him. He picked up the phone. There was no voice coming. He said, mother just called out his name, you know, like Kostu, like that something. He heard the mother's voice. And then he was only hearing, like that only, you know. Only this he was hearing. And he was calling, oh, what happened, mother, what happened? What happened? Why are you crying? And she was just, like this only. And the guy put the phone, ran away. A chaste lady like Mother Sita should be protected, even at the cost of building a bridge on the ocean. Samudra par pul bana kar bhi raksha karne chahiye aise stri ki. Even shastras glorify such devoted and devotional ladies. I'm talking about non-devotee mothers and non-devotee society. You understood? So she was crying. Mantra was just, Kaike was crying. Dasharatha Maharaj said, what happened? Tell me. I will just destroy the person. I will go to the three worlds also and find out that person and destroy him who has put you in this situation. He said, no, first you tell me one thing. Whatever I say, you will fulfill that. Tell me, Are Kai Kai, what are you telling? If you ask me to give my life today, I will give away. I am so happy. I have come here to share something very, very auspicious with you. I said, no, not that. First you give me a vow that you will fulfill what I say. He said, done. Radha Govind Maharaj mentioned that this is the biggest mistake a man will do in his life. Because the nature of a woman is like a child. Like a child. Insecure, fearful, and very defensive, fighting and lying when they become disturbed. They immediately lie. I don't know how many of you experienced, you know. I'm a Grihastha and I'm living in a society. And I've seen when women are insecure, they immediately start lying. One should never give a word that I fulfill all your desires. Never. Never give. Then Kai Kai told immediately that, okay, you remember I have these two boons? I said, yeah, I remember them very well. I'll give you 100 boons today. I said, no, I want only those two boons. So tell me, Devi, what you want? As far as the first boon, Bharat will become the king. Dasharatha Maharaj got a heart attack almost, you know. And he was shocked because even he knew that Kai Kai used to love Lord Ramachandra more than anyone. But he controlled himself and he said, what happened to you, Devi? Who has polluted your mind like this? Who has polluted your mind like this? Say, no, here my second boon. For the second boon, I want Rama to be banished in the jungle for 14 years. Dasharatha Maharaj heard this, he practically fainted there. He said, what are you talking? Tomorrow Rama is going to become the king. I am ready to accept. I will convince everyone with the same arrangements. Bharat will become the king. No problem for that. Rama will happily accept it. But don't think about it. Even the Even the thought of being separated for Rama, I'm feeling like leaving my body. Don't speak that. Don't speak this. Don't think that. Devi, this is not good. You know Ram. Ram is Sarva Guna Sampan. He is oceanic with all the good qualities. Everyone loves him. What to speak about? The citizens of Ayodhya, Devi. Even the species, even the beasts, even the lions, even the tigers, even the birds, even the horses, even the elephants, they all are in love with Rama. That is Rama. That is his beauty. Don't do this. He said, no, nothing doing. Practically he faints. Dashrath Maharaj first puts his helmet at the feet of Kaikai. Then he puts his head and then he feeds, sleeps and he faints down. He calls out Rama. Just the thought of separating from Rama, he was practically losing his life, fainting and again, whole night, getting up, requesting Kaikai, requesting her, I assure you, Bharat will happily accept, Rama will happily accept, Rama will not interfere in the kingdom's activity. Please, Devi, don't separate me and the whole Ayodhya from Rama. She said, no, nothing doing. You know, by that time, morning comes. Minister Sumanta, he searches Dashrath Maharaj. He didn't see Dashrath Maharaj in chamber. He comes to know he's in the Kupa Bhavan whole night. He rushes there. Dashrath Maharaj is lying down practically half dead. And Kaikai is sitting there, you know, half asleep. Sumanta comes there. He said, he sees the whole scene. And he tells, what happened? He says, nothing I want to tell you. First you do one thing, you go and immediately call Rama. Tell immediately Dashrath Maharaj to meet him. Sumanta goes running, goes and informs Lord Ramachandra. Lord Ramachandra was actually preparing to come out, and with Mother Sita he was discussing, because this morning was the Yajna. His Yajna to become the Raja Abhishek and become the king. So he told Sita that maybe there is something very important which father wants to discuss with me. I am going and immediately come back. He goes. He comes to Kupa Bhavan. Lord Ramachandra is in the state of shock to see father lying like this. Kaikai is sitting in old clothes without any jewelry. He comes inside practically almost eyes in tears. He is from his childhood. He has never seen his mother and father like this. And his goal was never to see mother and father in pain. So he was so disturbed to see this scene. And he came and he asked, oh my Lord, you know, generally the king or the father is as good as the Supreme Lord. He said, oh my Lord, what has happened to you? Why are you lying like this? Maharaj Dashrath was practically faint when he heard Lord Ramachandra's voice. Immediately he woke up, he saw Rama, started crying and he hugged Rama, started crying like a small baby, oh Rama, Rama, crying more and more. Kaikai, not able to speak anything. Not able to speak anything. And then Kaikai is there. Lord Ramachandra is looking at Kaikai. What happened to my father? He said, Rama, your great father, the king in the line of Ikshvaku, Surya Vamsha, he's crying because he's not able to fulfill his words. Ramachandra was shocked, struck his heart, because Kaikai had never spoken to him like this in the whole life. He's not able to fulfill his words. Ramachandra was shocked. He said, Devi, mother, what is that? I'm becoming very, very, very restless. Please tell me, what is this? What is this whole going on? Then she explained immediately. See, I had this whole two boons with your father, and I came to know they want to make you the king. For my boons, I requested him. See, I want Bharat to become the king. And for the second boon, I want you to go to the jungle for 14 years. And after hearing this, your father, he wants to get back from his boon. He doesn't get back from his words. He doesn't want to fulfill his word. He wants to spoil the name of his dynasty. And that is what has become like this. Very, very shamelessly, she spoke like this. You know? This is a teaching for all of us, you know. When, if you get into Grihastha Ashram without Brahmacharya training, you will face this kind of situations and you will fell prey to it. If you are a Brahman, if you have taken Brahman training, then you will know, Are Baba, ये तो औरत का आदत है बोलने का, ये बोलते रहिए कि मुझे अपना भक्ति करते रहना है. You understand? They don't do anything. They go on talking. So then, now Ramachandra, see here, very beautifully, this is where Lord Ramachandra's qualities as an adult, as a Maryada Purushottam. Of course, firstly, when he goes with Vishwamitra, was one when he was a small 7-8 years old boy, Vishwamitra takes him to kill the demon Rakshasas. There also, and now onwards, you will see the beautiful qualities of Ramachandra. How he deals, how he abides a duty of a son, how he fulfills the duty of a brother, how he fulfills the duty of a husband. Lord Ramachandra is completely relaxed and he is having a smile. And with a smile, he is telling his father and looking at Kaikeyi. He tells that only this much. This much, these two bones or anything else is there. If there is something else, you tell me. This much. And I am feeling very pain to see my father like this. And Bharat, amongst all of them, Bharat is the most qualified to become the king. He's the most qualified to become the king. And mother, if you wanted me to go for Vanvas, first thing though, I am myself feeling some good fortune has come in my life. Because I was always thinking that all the rishis and sages, those who come to meet my father in Ayodhya, they all reside in the jungles. And I would think as a prince, in this lifetime, will I ever get an opportunity to go and associate with them, stay in their hermitage, serve them, and hear from them spiritual subjects. So I feel the Lord is very merciful upon me and He has fulfilled my desire. Kaikeyi was shaken and Dashrath having tears to see his son's qualities. See, it is a very great teaching for all of us that this material assets, material possessions or material desires, if unfulfilled, they have no value because they are temporary. One should not be so overly attached. One should be so Krishna conscious that he can immediately act according to Krishna consciousness philosophy in any situation in the material life. You understood? Look at Lord Ramachandra. He's going to become the king in few hours. And he's told you make Bharat the king. He's blissful. Oh, Bharat is so qualified. So qualified. You have to go to the jungle. Oh, what a fortune. You understood? What a fortune. And that is how Vaishnava should deal with the material discomforts. Immediately apply Vaishnava philosophy. Immediately approach the Guru and Sadhu or the Shastras. This material world is temporary. Everything is temporary. And he said, and then he told Mother Kaikeyi that my heart is in pain to see my father like this. If you wanted to give me this fortune of going to the jungle, you could have told me this any moment of life. You need not wait for this moment when I was going to be declared as a king. Had you told me any moment of my life, Mother, just to prove my love to you, I would have left Ayodhya without informing anyone. And at least my father, my dear father, would not be in this situation. Kaikeyi was stuck. And in this material world, when you act as a Vaishnava, when you act with detachment, the person opposite is shaken. Isn't it true? That's how when you see many of our devotees are going out and meeting new people. People are shocked to see young boys, dhoti kurta, trying to speak some philosophy. Isn't it true? They are shocked. Isn't it true? Because they are sitting on the ocean of material attachment and floating there in the lap of Maya. And they are seeing these young boys don't desire that. Correct or not? Huh? They don't desire that. Even the parents are shocked. They say, inko brainwash kar diya hai, ye pagal ho gaye hai, in loko duba diya hai, barbaad kar diya hai, kahi ka nahi bacha hai. Kya bano? Daru piyo aur Romeo bano. Wo chalega. Khali paisa kamao chalo. Isn't it true? That is accepted. Huh? That is, they're proud of it. They're proud of it. There's a woman hunter, alcoholic, meat eater, isn't it true? Chalega wo, nahi? Ram bhakt ban gaya to are barbaad ho gaya hum log. Kyun paida hua tu hum log mein? Hum log ne kya paap kiya? Correct? Tell me. Sumit, just recent experience. He came running, ghar se bhag kya hai, 2 days pehle. No? राम भक्त बनोगे तो माता पिता रोएंगे. पगार अच्छा हो कुछ भी करो चलेगा. अनफॉर्चुनेटली ये समाज है अभी. बट डिटैचमेंट टू मटीरियल थिंग इज सो अमेजिंग. व्हेन यू हियर अबाउट इट यू वांट टू हियर इट मोर. इजंट इट ट्रू? दिस इज ब्यूटी, दिस इज स्वीटनेस, दिस इज कॉल्ड रसा. ओनली हार्ट कैन एक्सपीरियंस दिस. This is not something mind and tongue can experience. This is called rasa, Krishna katha. Heart experiences it. And Lord Ramachandra said, okay, I'm preparing. And immediately walks off. And he goes, straight goes to Kaushalya, his mother. And tells her that, you know, I have to leave immediately for Vanavas. Father has given this boon to Kaikai. Kaikai wanted Bharat to become the king. So I'm leaving, mother. Practically, Kaushalya started crying. He said, Ram! What are you made of? This is the limit of your glories. There's no limit to your glories. How can you speak like this, Ram? In this world, nobody can be like this. You are going to become the king for a few hours and you are just giving up like someone remove the dust from his shirt like this, just does like the dust goes. That's how you are giving him up. You're going. Oh, it is so easy for you to speak, but will I be alive after that? Then he said, no, mother. Father has given the boon. If I have to be a true son, and I want your blessing to be a true son, please allow me to go. By that time, mother Sita comes there. And she's hearing this whole conversation. And then Lord Ramachandra looks at Sita and he tells her, you stay back and take care of the mother-in-law and father-in-law. He doesn't say, Mata and Pita. He doesn't say my mother and father. He tells her your mother-in-law and your father-in-law. He describes mother Sita's relationship, that your relationship is with them and you take care of their duty. And mother Sita has practically heard the whole thing and she's just in tears. He said, no, I will come with you. No, you be in Ayodhya. And then in the Ramayana, there's a beautiful, Lord Ramachandra is describing as a normal materialist would, like, you know, when you become a devotee and you speak philosophy, how the people in the world will teach you, are paisa nahi ho to kaise hoga, ye sab bolne ki baat hai, isn't it true? So, started telling, Lord Ramachandra was just trying to preach her that jungle is very dangerous, there are wild animals there. And very, very hot in summers. I'll be barefoot. I know if I'm barefoot, you will also not wear anything. And you are brought up as a queen, as a princess. You are a princess in Janakpur and you are a queen in Ayodhya. How will you face it? In winters, it's too cold. And all the streets are full of thorns. Dangerous animals are living. Mother Sita said, when you are there, what is the fear for me? And where is the fear for me? And let anything happen to me if you are around. I don't mind. And for me, Ayodhya means where Lord Ram is. If Ram is in the jungle, that is Ayodhya. He is in the palace, that is Ayodhya. He is in the road, that is Ayodhya. So this is the quality of Sita. And Mother Ramachandra again preached her. Said, no, okay, fine. I am going to fulfill the duty of my... As a son, I am fulfilling the duty and responsibility and order of my father. She said, okay, fine, my master. I also have the order of my father. He told me, from this moment of your marriage, everything of Ram becomes half of you. You are practically half of Ram. Actually, this is why a wife is called Ardha Angini. Isn't true? Ardha Angini. Half of the body of the husband. So that is why half of your vanvas is mine, half of your pains are mine, half of the pleasures are mine. So that is why I will go with you. Otherwise, you have to give me one permission. Lord Ramachandra saw some hopes that she will stay back. She said, yes, I will stay back at one condition. When you leave, you allow me to leave to Shamshan. Dead. You allow me to leave this world when you leave Ayodhya. Lord Ramachandra said, okay, fine, you come. As I told yesterday, when this whole thing happened, Kaushalya was crying. And Lord Ramachandra pacified, you have to take care of father. He will reject Kaikai. So that is why he'll come to you. You only have to take care of father. Now immediately, as I told yesterday, Lakshman comes running. He comes to know. So, kya hua? Kya suna maine? Kya chal raha hai yahan par? What is going on here? Then he, Ramachandra told him, say, no, nothing doing. You are, will become the king of Ayodhya. Nobody can stop that. What Dasharatha has given a vow boon, forget all these things. You will become the king and nobody can stop this. Ayodhya belongs to you eternally. Lord Ramachandra tries to pacify Lakshman. I said, Lakshman, just cool down. He said, no. He said, then our father, Dasharatha cannot speak like this, he said. Dasharatha cannot speak like this. He has no rights. Eldest son will become the king and you have to become the king. Even at the cost of killing Dasharatha, no problem. But soldiers are coming, ministers are coming. I'll wipe off the whole Ayodhya. And then you will become the king. Then Lord Ramachandra chastises and pacifies him first. He said, no, this has never happened. In the Ikshvaku Kul, in the Surya Vamsha, no son has rejected or disobeyed father for anything material, for a position, for power. This has never happened. If that is the case, he falls at the feet of Lord Rama and tells him, see, even for me, from my childhood, for me, everything is you. Everything is you. For me, mother and father is you. I don't know anyone except you in Ayodhya. For me, my mother, my father, my friend, my brother, my life and soul, everything is you. I request you. Mother Sita, you are taking, while in the journey, I will cut some fruits. I'll make houses. I'll make huts. I'll protect you. I'll be a maid servant. Please take me with you. I cannot live without you, my dear brother. My dear Rama. Starts crying. And Lord Ramachandra knew that Lakshmana cannot stay. He said, okay, at one condition. Go and take permission from Sumitra. Who is Sumitra? Mother of? And? Shatrughna. So he immediately runs, practically runs. It is said that Lakshmana's feet were not touching the earth. He was practically running like a spring. Ting, 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 ting. Immediately went and reached Mother Sumitra and told her everything. Like a small child crying and breathing loudly. He explained the mother. And Sumitra was standing there. And she started having tears in her eyes. Now you see, this is the quality of a father who understands the value of Rama. Or a devotee. Devotion to Rama. Sumitra says that, Lakshman, my dear son, today I feel proud of being your mother. Today, I feel my body is auspicious because you are born from me. You are not born for anything else except serve Lord Rama. For you, Sita is mother and Rama is father. And don't look back at Ayodhya or anyone else. Just go. Just go and serve Rama. Nothing else is your life. And for me, I will just live remembering that you are Ram's servant. I can live rest of the life and die with this pleasure that you are Ram's. Radha Govind Maharaj mentioned, Vastav mein is dunya ki har maa ki yahi ichha honi chahiye. कि मेरा बेटा राम का भक्त बने और कुछ भी नहीं बने. That is a true motherhood. And my child should become a son of the devotee of Lord Rama. Then Lord Lakshman immediately takes permission and they leave. And as I mentioned, they go to Chitrakoot. First they meet Guhu. Then they go to Chitrakoot from there. After Chitrakoot, Bharat comes there. And I cannot speak, it is another 1 hour story. You know, Bharata's coming back and then his discussion with Kaikai. He is leaving Ayodhya. Practically half of the Ayodhya is traveling with to bring Lord Ramachandra back. And because Chitrakut is the place where Bharat and Rama had met, and all the citizens have come, kings have come, Lord Ramachandra started feeling very painful, and those thoughts of Bharat were coming again and again. Because Bharat loves Lord Rama so much, so they left and came to Dandakaranya. And they started living here. So this temple, beautiful temple of Lakshmanji is here. It is a symbol, because even in Dandakaranya, in Chitrakut, when Lakshman was guarding, and Mother Sita and Lord Ramachandra were living there, Lakshman would go on the top of the trees, on the top of the mountains, and make sure any beasts, demons, rakshasas are not there to disturb Rama and Mother Sita. So one day, when Bharat was coming with his whole army, from the far, Lakshman saw the flag of Ayodhya. Then he came down running from the mountain. He went inside to the cottage of Chitrakut and immediately started taking his bow, arrows, armor, getting ready. He said, "My lord, get ready." He said, "What happened?" He said, no, wear everything. You also get ready. By the fortune, a great opportunity has come. He said, "What is that opportunity, Lord Rama?" said, "What is this opportunity?" "Array, I just saw the flag of Ayodhya. Looks like Bharat and Shatrughan are coming. They are coming with the whole soldiers to have a war." Bharat coming for a war? Lord Ramachandra could not understand. He said, "My lord, you are very innocent. You are like a small child. You don't understand. You don't understand anything. That is why we are also here with you. You are a small child. You don't know why is he coming? He wants to make sure that after 14 years you don't come back also. And for me, it is such a fortune, such an opportunity. I'll wipe off everyone. After that, we don't have to wait for 40 years. We can immediately go back." Lord Ramachandra was shaken. See the anger. But this anger of Lakshman is out of love for Lord Rama. And Lord Ramachandra said, no, Bharat will never do like this. For Bharat must be just coming to meet me. Because he was not there, no, when we met. I said, "You are innocent, my lord. I know what is Bharat. I know what is Shatrughan. I saw everything what Kaikai did." Lord, and then he looks at Sita. "Inhone kisi mein kabhi kuch galti dekhna sikhai nahi." And then Lord Ramachandra actually chastises. He said, "No, by Bharat will never do like this. And if you feel so, and if you are so eager to go and become the king, wait. Let Bharat come. I will tell Bharat to stay back with me. And you can go and become the king of Ayodhya." Lakshman heard this, he just like a heart attack. He immediately fell down on the feet and practically did Abhishek with his tears of the feet of Lord Rama. He said, "My lord, please forgive me, but I am in so much anxiety." He said, "No, Bharat will never do, wait." Then Bharat comes, he sees Lakshman, Lord Rama in the, dressed as Vanvasis. Bharat faints there and Lakshman sees that. And then Lakshman feels so much painful, immediately runs, picks him up, and this way Lakshman actually understands. And throughout the 14 years, Lakshman would serve Lord Ramachandra whole day, and in the night he would not sleep. The Tapavan is a place, it's a symbol that Lord Lakshmana would never sleep whole night. He would just be awake protecting Lord Rama and Mother Sita. That is why also we should know Lakshman is Guru Tattva. Lakshman, you see, there is Shesha on his head. He meets Balaramji. This means spiritual master. Lord Lakshman is the expansion of Lord Balaram, just like Nityananda Prabhu. Just like Nityananda Prabhu. He is the Adi Guru, the spiritual master, who guides the living entities in the world. How to practice bhakti, how to come to Krishna. So he's Adi Guru. We should pray to Lord Lakshman, this beautiful only temple of Lord Lakshmana. In fact, there is one more thing which the Puranas mentioned, that Lakshmana had to face so many difficulties because he had to accept Lord Rama coming to jungle. He had to accept, Dasharath allowing Kaikai's desires being fulfilled. He had to accept, citizens doubting Mother Sita. He could not do anything. When the citizen doubted, he wanted to kill the wife of the whole citizens. But he could not do. Ram did not allow him. Then he did not want to go and leave Mother Sita in the jungle. But he had to do that. After that, he went to Lord Ramachandra's pastimes got over. He went to Lord and he told him, no more younger brother in any leelas. No more younger brother in any leelas. I will only come as elder brother only. That's why when he come as Krishna Balaram, Balaram is elder brother. When he come as Lord Chaitanya Nityananda, Nityananda is elder to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So in this way, Lord Balaram spread. And Hanumanji, what to speak about glories of Hanuman who is here. Ramachandra, when he comes back from Ayodhya, he actually rewards everyone. When it comes to Hanuman, Ramachandra has tears in his eyes. And he wakes, he stands up from his throne and he says, Hanuman, your devotion to me is, there is no limit to it. There is no way one can measure it. Your selflessness has just touched my heart so deeply. And I am so helpless and I feel so unqualified to reward you something. In my possession, I don't have anything which I can reward you with. But I have one thing. I can offer myself to you. And he goes and embraces Hanuman and cries. That is devotion. Because Hanuman took so much pain to serve Lord Ramachandra without any doubt or without any question or without any expression of discomfort. Positively, always in service of Lord Ramachandra. And then there is a Gautam Rishi's ashram. Gautam Ganga is also here. He was residing here long ago. That's the story how Parvati Ganga Devi comes here also in South India. You know, I'll tell later on. It's too late. We have to go for the breakfast. Sisitaram Lakshman Hanuman ki. Shri Lakshman ji ki. Tapavan ki. Shri Prabhupada ki. Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Om.